Thank you, everybody. Okay. I'm so glad I brought my fan club over here. Okay. Good evening, family and friends, and thank you all for being here tonight to celebrate the newlyweds. I stand before you as the maid of honor of my big sister, Allie. I'm already crying. Writing a speech and coming up with what to say has been one of the hardest things I've ever had to do. Not only because Allie has been my ghostwriter since third grade, but because how do I explain to a room full of people what it's like to have a sister like Allie? How do I explain that I... Cut. Literally. All right, thank you. Okay. How do I explain that I literally wouldn't be able to make it through life without her? Growing up only 2 years apart and sharing a bedroom for nearly half of our lives meant we had no choice but to be close. And as far as I was concerned, we were a package deal. If Allie was invited to a sleepover, I had my bag packed and ready to go. To Megan's house, usually. If she got a new Old Navy sweatsuit, I got the same one in a different color. And if she played a sport, I was running on the field right behind her. I wanted to snuggle up on her top bunk until it was time for bed, sit in the bathroom while she showered to talk about absolutely nothing, steal her clothes, wear her makeup, and everything in between. And Allie, being the patient, compassionate big sister, would let me do all of those things. As Allie and I have grown up side by side and shaped our lives together, there has always been one word that perfectly describes her relationship towards me: selfless. It wasn't until recently that I realized how extraordinary that was. Allie has gone her whole life to always make me feel loved and included. I owe not just some, but all of my favorite memories to her. I have some of my greatest friendships because of her. I've never felt like an afterthought. I've never felt left out. And I've never even felt younger. I spent my whole life bossing Allie around and testing the limits of how far I can go with her. Mom, wherever you are, you can attest to that. But the truth is, no matter how far I went, Allie was always the same. She wipes my tears when I cry. She knows all of the right things to say to calm me down, and she makes me laugh like no other. She's my best friend in the entire world, and I'm so proud of the woman that she is. Woo! Woo! Love you. Allie is the most selfless person I know, and I never thought I'd meet anyone that would come as close to her until we met Ryan. Ryan. Woo! Not only do you surpass Allie, but you blew her out of the freaking water. You're thoughtful, kind, genuine, loving, goofy, and every other good quality you could name. You couldn't be more perfect for my sister if I had to handpick her myself. You are everything she needs in a lifelong partner. Your personality is infectious, and you are the biggest yes man that I've ever met. Whether it's ordering 50 Chick-fil-A nuggets, putting on a concert in your own living room, or rallying at baseball games, you give it 1,000%. And I can see so clearly that you do that in your relationship with Allie too. You've provided her a safe place to be her true self, which we both know can be questionable. And you compliment each other so well. Most of all, thank you for not being selfish with her. You have always respected, welcomed, and understood our deep bond. You've made it clear that you're not only here for her, but that you have also accepted me and all that comes with this crazy-ass family of ours. Even if it means something, sometimes having to listen to our calls, complaining about our significant others. Love you. Love you too, Kyle. I love you both very much, and I hope you have as much fun growing old with her as I did growing up with her. So to Allie and Ryan, raise your glasses. And now I can drink! Woo! Woo! It's my turn. For those who don't know me, I am the biological Vertola sister. Allie and I quickly became like sisters from having a sleepover practically every weekend from second grade through high school, from giving me advice about boys and friendship to instruction and differentiation in the classroom. Allie has always been the yin to my yang. Where I am soft, Allie has always been solid. Where I am way too dramatic, Allie has always been clear-headed. And while I always ate the red fruit snacks at lunch in elementary school, Allie always ate the orange. No matter what it was in life, the highs and the lows, I could always count on Allie to be there unapologetically. Allie keeps her circle small because if she considers you a friend, she will show up for you with no judgment. And let's face it, there's only so many people you can do that for. When Allie met Ryan, I knew he was the one for her because Ryan is me. Although we both talk way too much and have way too many friends for Allie to keep up with, I know she loves him because he is the yin to her yang. They balance each other out perfectly, and it has been my pleasure to watch them grow into the couple they are today. I know that no matter where life takes them, they will always be there for each other, continuing to balance each other out and make each other better for years to come. And I can't wait to be around for it all. So let's raise a glass to the happy couple. We love you.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen. Make some noise for our maids of honor, Courtney and Megan. All right, friends and family, coming up next, make some noise and put those hands together for the best men, Anthony and Colin.
Hey, Ryan. So me and V met way, way back, all thanks to my buddy Colin here. We spent countless hours at the famous Quinn Memorial Field. Those manhunt games turned into late nights listening to Led Zeppelin, Bruce Springsteen at the Van Vliet's. Big shout out to Miss Kim and Mr. Kev for putting up with us. Although Mr. Kev would be right there with us, turning up the volume. Sorry, Allie, but I hope those nights never end. I remember when V and Allie first met. He texted me that very day to get the inside scoop, and now the rest is history. Before one of their first dates, V and I were at the Firehouse Pub in Rahway. Allie texted him to hang out. Being the guy that he is, he asked if I could tag along. Pretty sure I was the seventh wheel on that date. But I was just happy for Allie and Ryan. Happy to be there. All of those memories lead us up to today. You both look amazing and wish you a lifetime of love and happiness. Now let's get this party started in the house that Bruce built.
Bruce,
Bruce.
So for those of you who don't know, I've known Ryan a long time. One day, me and my brother were outside of our house at Quinn Memorial Field. My brother, aunt, a bunch of us were outside, and this kid walks down the street. Yankee Derek Jeter jersey on, blonde tips, a wooden bat from a Yankee Stadium bat day. And I can't tell you what he said to cement him into our group. Could have been that he had a pool, but that's neither here nor there. From there, it was every day. I was at his house, he was at my house. Our dads coached Little League together. We spent our childhoods together. And we spent our high school years together. And our college years together. Even though I went away, my roommates always knew to ask, is Vivi coming this week? And through those years, he has never changed. He's remained Vivi, a kid that would do anything for someone he loves. He's someone who gets excited about things, which is infectious when you're around it. He makes all of his friends laugh, and Allie, I know he makes you laugh. Now, Allie, let's get to the meeting Allie part. Ryan begins work as, what else? A gym teacher. If you would ask me at 8... If you would ask me at 8 years old what Ryan would have been when he grew up, I would have said, shortstop for the Yankees, or a gym teacher. So they both begin work together in Linden. So Ryan comes up to me and goes, Ryan, Kyle, I met this chick. She's hot, she's cool, blah, blah, blah. I go, Ryan, you guys work in the same school. It's a horrible idea. And I guess they progress. And one Christmas Eve night, we are at Butch Cole's. And I get a tap on my shoulder, and it's Ryan. And he says, hey, man, I'm going to see a chick from my school. I go, Ryan, it's Christmas Eve. And he goes, I'm going to go to the chick's house. I said, all right, you're going to the chick's house. So there's that. Fast forward to now. They've bought a house together. They both have started new jobs, so they don't work in the same place, which is good. They have Bruce, their dog, and they've built a great life together. Allie, a word of advice. Ryan is going to be Ryan. Do not let him drive you crazy. Someone once told me, true love is your soul's recognition of its counterpoint in another. And I couldn't be more happy for the both of you. Everybody, let's have a good time.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen, at this time, make some noise for our best men, Anthony and Colin. Well, you can tell everybody. Yeah, you can tell everybody. Go ahead and tell everybody.